Procainamide blocks sodium channels, which prolongs the refractory period of both the atria and the ventricles. Also, the speed of interventricular conduction is slowed down. This prolongs the QT, QRS, and the PR intervals. So what are some of the indications? For children and infants, procainamide may be used to treat various atrial and ventricular arrhythmias. It could be used to treat hemodynamically stable SVT, refractory to vagal maneuvers, and adenosine because it can terminate SVT that is resistant to other medications. It's also effective in treating atrial flutter, atrial fibrillation, and in suppressing pulsed VTAC. So what are the precautions and contraindications? Well, caution needs to be used because it's paradoxically shortening the effective refractory period of the AV node and increases AV nodal conduction. It may cause increased heart rate when used to treat ectopic atrial tachycardia and atrial fibrillation. Procainamide, like amiodarone, may increase the risk of polymorphic ventricular tachycardia, otherwise known as torsades de pointes. Use of procainamide along with other agents like amiodarone that prolong the QT interval is not recommended without expert consultation. Due to its potent vasodilating effect, it can cause hypotension in children. The dose should be reduced for patients with poor renal or cardiac function. So what are the pediatric dosages then? Well, the initial dose should be an infusion of 15 milligrams per kilogram over 30 to 60 minutes with continuous ECG monitoring and frequent blood pressure monitoring. Procainamide must be given by slow infusion to avoid toxicity from heart block hypotension and prolongation of the QT interval.